Tilapia nest building. Hi everybody, welcome again to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. A few weeks ago I shared with you that my broodstock was actually placed within this pond, right? I shared with you the fact that this pond, well, this tote, right, was actually collapsing and that I could not fill it up to the top. This is a 250 1000 liter tote, right? And I normally keep my fingerlings in here, and then I ended up start to keep my tilapia broodstock in here. Then I moved the broodstock from this location to the next booster location. However, hold on a sec, I see a tadpole and I'm trying to catch it. Right, so I have a tadpole in my hand and I'm gonna feed it too. Oops. Oh, I don't want it to jump. It's jumping. Oh, it's jumping. It's not gonna escape. Got it. I'm gonna feed it to my handpick cichlid. And they got it before I even turn around the camera to actually look at it, right? All right, so let's get back to the video. All right, so I'm not straying from the topic, I'm just sharing something with you, right? So these are my 1-inch fingerlings. I need to keep them here for about another month, and then I'll transfer them to another location, and then I'll put another sack here. So that's how I keep rotating them. So they are actually going nice. They're about 1 inch. You have a few that is a little bit underneath 1 inch, but they are going on okay. All right, so this is where I keep my broodstock. I have 9 tilapia fish. Now when I was moving them from this location to this location, about 5 of them had eggs and fries that were underdeveloped in their mouth. And you know, the movement from one space to the next, they actually regurgitate it, or should I say, spit it out. And I never had the time or the capacity to actually place it within a space so that they could hatch, right? The pond is a little bit nasty right now because the water needs to be changed. However, I'm a little bit cautious. Why am I cautious? Because I'm seeing the males actually... Oh, by the way, when I actually started to do tilapia, right, tilapia videos, I was kind of optimistic as to, you know, going forward, I would always have a male and a female. Now, I kept consuming, you know, catching and consuming the males and the females and eat them, right, consume their food, right? And I was worried at one point in time whether or not I have males and females. Now, I saw about 4 or 5 of them having eggs in their mouth, and I was wondering whether or not I have females. In looking at the pond right now, I can assure myself that I do have males. Only male tilapia makes the nest. And so far, I have seen about 4 nests. So each nest represents the whole idea of the male laying, the male laying out the space for the female to actually lay the egg, and then now it will ferment it. And you know, because it is not a monogamous type of relationship between the male and the female will actually go, and probably the male will actually make another nest, and another female will come along, and eggs will be laid and fertilized and go along. Now, as you can see, there's a nest. And the nest is that little bald spot within the base of the pond that have been shifted by the fish, right? So that's a nest, right? And that's another nest. And that's another nest over there, right? And that's another nest over there. And normally it's the male who defends the nest, right? Defends any other fish from coming into the nest, while the female would actually hide from... you know, the torment of the male water is a little bit chilly right now, guys. Trust me, it's a little bit chilly. And for them to actually breed, it needs to be a little bit warmer. But there's no pond warmer out here. I mean, the tropics, the temperature is normally between 28 to 32 degrees. Because of the cold temperature coming from north, meaning North America, in between November and December, you find is that the air is kind of getting chilly right now because North America is kind of thawing out. So we are kind of getting a little coolish temperature, right? But these are the nests, and this is the primary focus of today's video, right? So the females will actually lay the eggs in the nest. The male will actually fertilize the eggs with the mint, and she will move along her way. And I've noticed a few things with this batch of broodstocking which I have, is that up to about a week ago, they were all consuming and everybody was good, right? And about 3 days after, right, I realized that only a few started to consume. Now, based on the behavior, the nesting and you know, the picking with the eating and all that, I can figure more or less that they have eggs in their mouth. That's the females. There are 9 tilapia in this pond, right? 9 of them, right? And they do have, it seems as if the females have eggs in their mouth, and so I am awaiting them to actually release so I can actually get the fries and actually place it in a safe space. Now, this pond was originally used to keep the fingerlings that are over on this side, right? Yeah, water is a little bit greener because it's more directly in the sun. It doesn't have anything over it like this one has the zinc, right? And it's a little bit warmer too. It's not that cold like, well, it's a little chilly, but not that cold like the one in the broodstock, right? But as you all know, with tilapia is known to manage differences in fall in temperature, pH, and water quality. So it's an excellent fish for outdoors, it's an excellent fish for ponds, and it's very tough for aquaponics, right? So hopefully within the next probably about a week or so, I should see some amount of fries in the pond. I was gonna place my GoPro in the water space, however you might not be able to see much because water is a little bit messy, right? I don't mind it being messy. I changed water a week ago. I don't mind it being messy because when it's messy, when it's green or, you know, like a not clear, when the fries are released, they feel a little bit more safe and not intimidated by the adults. I don't think the adults will actually consume them. It's the fingerlings that I would have been worried about, right? Normally, I would have kept the broodstock in this space where in which I have the 2-inch and, wow, the water is chilly too, right? The 2-inch and the more like 3-inch tilapia fingerlings, right? Yeah, these are the larger ones, and you can see them, right? So normally I keep the broodstock here and the babies will be swimming like at the edges and I will actually extract them. I would have shifted it around because I wanted this space to be a kind of aquaponics center, right? I'm still not yet up and running with that because of some logistical issues, but it's in the pipeline. It's hope that you actually enjoy this video. Remember to share, like, and subscribe. Thank you very much for stopping by, guys. Peace out. Catch you next time. Bye-bye.